Why, hello there, everybody. How you doing today? It's me again and again. I'm here to encourage. I'm here to empower. I'm here to embolden. I'm here to inform. I'm here to build you up. I'm here to lift you up. I'm here to educate you. I'm here to give and bring you peace. I'm here to give and bring you hope, because I am here to give, bring, and tell you the truth. Hopefully you're enjoying your day after Thanksgiving. And it's time to get back to work for me. That's how I look at everything. Yesterday was a holiday. We enjoyed the holiday. Now it's time to get back to the brass tacks. Transforming our country back to what it was designed to be. Undoing all the damage. We have a lot of work to do, folks. We have a lot of work to do. Now, a lot of people are upset about not what President-elect Trump said, but the definition of what President-elect said concerning the Clintons. Listen who you're listening to, folks. You're listening to people who have been out and out lying to you. They're trying to agitate. I'm going to tell you what I heard, point blank. I heard President-elect Donald J. Trump say, "I don't want to hurt the woman, but if you're going to make me the bad guy, I'll be the bad guy." I heard the President-elect, the 45th President-elect of the United States of America, tell Congress, "It's time for you to do your damn job." Tell the FBI, "It's time for you to do the damn job." Tell the Department of Justice, "It's time for you to do the damn job." Now, you see, they can't hurry up and do anything about it right now. But what he's saying is, once we get in, I fully expect you all to take care of this. I can't be the bad guy. I'm not going to be the heavy for everything. That's just my feeling. She's going down. She is going down. Obama's going down. These people have been violating little children right there in Washington, D.C. It's sick. It's disgusting. And you all don't want to deal with it because you can't believe that somebody could actually do all that. You think that only that stuff only happens in movies. It happens everywhere, even where you live. And the reason why it happens everywhere, even where you live, is because you, the church, the body of Christ, has allowed it to happen because we have watered down the gospel. We have watered down righteousness. We have watered down holiness. And we have let others come in and define what Christianity is. Now, I'm just going to leave it at that. But that's about to change. That is changing. It is changing. We have taught far too many people, far too many professing Christians who have one foot in the world and another foot in the church, professing. That is straddling the fence. You know what happens when you straddle the fence? Bad things happen to you when you straddle the daggum fence. All right. Now, the reason why they are saying that, Trump is not going to do anything about it, is because they want to keep that in the forefront. They know she's toast. She knows she's toast. So they want to keep it making it an issue. Again, it's going to be resolved. Do you really think that Almighty God is going to allow these people to murder all these people? You know about it. Are you going to allow it? Pick up the daggum phone. I said it in day before yesterday's video. Pick up the phone. Tell your congressman what you want done. You, me, we are the government. They are public servants, folks. But you see, you don't want to be held accountable. You don't want somebody coming in looking into you. Now, I'm going to tell you, I'm a tap dance on some toes right now. Okay? Well, no, first let me finish my thought with this. They are trying to create another situation to prevent they're trying to manipulate and control, trying to create a rabbit path that, oh, you have to do this, you have to do that, you have to do this, you have to do that. Son, that man, you do not become a billionaire. You do not build up a business to be worth $10 billion by going down rabbit trails. You do it by staying focused. And that's exactly what he's doing. So again, that was the message that he gave to the Congress, to the senators, as well as to all his appointees. I don't want to do it. You just better make sure that you do your job. That's the problem. People have been choosing to overlook and not doing their job. And you, me, we have allowed them. We have not held them accountable. Well, different day, different hour, different set of rules now, folks. It's accountability time. These people are going to be held accountable. So what they're trying to do is they're trying to slow down any kind of progress. That is their goal. I saw a story that all the Obama administration people, all the appointees, they become civil servants. And then they stay in there and they try to hinder the Republican agenda. Does that sound like somebody working for you? That sounds like somebody that's working against you, to me. Sounds like somebody trying to screw with your brain. Trying to tear you down from the inside out. That's called treason. Somebody that wants to get their way. But that's what's going on, and it's going to be removed. It's time for these people to be removed. It's time to take away their loudspeaker, the media. It's time for people to be held accountable. We are so conditioned, just to show you how conditioned we are, to trying to tell people what they can and cannot do and what they're allowed and not allowed to do. Here in Jacksonville, Florida, they ran a story. These people actually went and looked into where people who get an EBT card, and then some people are given cash, $200. Then they go in and they looked at where these people withdrew the money from. And they were like, oh man, these people are getting the money out at a strip club. So it's their money. Oh, they can't spend that money there. I'm sorry, whose money is it? See how quick that goes. And then you say, oh no, that's my money. That's taxpayers' money. Yeah, that's taxpayers' money. So then if you got a problem with how much money they're getting, ooh, boy, gnats, I hope they don't go down my throat today. If you have a problem with that, then do something about that. If you have a problem that somebody's getting something, then go and work on it. But don't, once they get it, it's legal. They didn't steal it. That's just like me coming into your house and saying, okay, let me see your checkbook. Let me see your bank records. Let me see where you spend. Oh, what is this? You've been at the bar every night this week and you've been spending $100? What are you, a lush? Hello? What have you been doing online? What is this? What kind of phone numbers you been calling? That's none of your damn business. But suddenly, because you think that's your money, it was no longer, that's the government's money as soon as you gave it to them. Dummy. Dummy. That's the government's. If you have a problem with what the government is doing with your money, then you do something about that. But these people haven't stolen anything. Did it ever cross your mind, you brain-dead media, that maybe that's the only place in the neighborhood because it's low income. It's not like they've got a Publix down the road. Hello. It's not like they got a bank down the road. Hello. Maybe that's the only place that those people could actually get money out. Well, they could drive across town. Yeah, you kind of need a car to drive across town. See how stupid that is. Why are you so worried about what somebody else is doing with what's been given to them? And that just shows you how sick we are. We really think that we have control over everybody else. And you think that you are in a position to rule over someone else. You think anybody that says they need to explain why they're getting that money out from an ATM machine at a strip club, they believe they're up here and the person that's doing that is down here. It's self-classification, folks. We have been brainwashed. We have been confused by the lying media. We're so worried about what somebody else is doing simply because we're so afraid of being exposed for the fake and fraud that we are. Squeaky wheel gets the oil. There's some oil for you. How you like it? Okay? So when we are all equal. We are all equal. The law applies to us all. Is there anything illegal about going into a strip club and using an ATM machine to get money out? No. Is there anything illegal about a strip club? No. So why in the world are you worried about it? And here's another thing. They are worried about, look, I got this receipt from Walmart. I saw it on the ground. And it says that these people bought lobster. Okay. Again, whose money is it? That's my money. No, that's their money. You gave that money to the government. That's just like that. And then the government gave it to them. Again, if you don't like how much money the government has given to them, then do something about it. You do something about it. All they're doing is they're just operating underneath the system. They are just like Donald Trump. Donald Trump said the same thing. He said, "Of course, I'm going to use the loopholes, the tax loopholes. Just like all of your donors use the tax loopholes. That's why they're there, to be used. Oh my God, I can't believe you didn't pay taxes. He's not the only one, folks. That's why the loopholes are there. Hello." Hello, and they don't want to get rid. They just want to make it seem like that he violated the law. He didn't violate. Did he violate the law? No. Okay, sit down, shut up. Same thing by going over and trying to tell somebody what they're supposed to do with their money. That's their business. Is it affecting you? No, got no effect on you. Well. They took the money from you. The government's going to take the money from you anyway. Idiot. How about let's work on having the government take less money from you. Hello? Then the government has less money to give out. Hello? So that will appease you all. Another thing the media does, we just had Hurricane Matthew pass off the shore. Didn't even hit us. These people were acting like it was going to come ashore. And it was the end of the world. And these media are out down at Jacksonville Beach, and they put in a curfew. And this is exactly what the reporter said. Talk about, you tell me if this sounds like somebody that thinks that they're superior to somebody. Comes up and says, well, we've had the Jacksonville Beach police come out here twice to inform us that there's a curfew on. And we told them, well, we're the media. Basically, it doesn't apply to us. Your curfew doesn't apply to us because we're up here. You're an imbecile. And then that very same reporter turned around and said, oh, look, they got somebody walking around out here. while she's walking around out there. Oh, no, no, they're not supposed to do that. They're breaking the law. Well, then, if they're breaking the law, then guess what? So will you, you idiot. These are brain-dead, dangerous people. Now, all of this brings me, I said all of that just to say, bring it back to me and my situation and why I know it's over with. Folks, the crime is the record. There are two court cases, and I evidently you all are kind of slow. Because this is what happens every time I start talking about this. Everybody says, well, what happened? What happened is, you're looking at what happened. Well, were you arrested? No, I was falsely detained / falsely imprisoned, kidnapped, and held for ransom. And then I had to pay the ransom to get out. I had to pay the ransom to the kidnappers to regain my liberty, my freedom. And the problem that they're having, why they don't want to look into it, is the very problem that they're having, and why I can say Hillary Clinton's going to go down and Barack Hussein Obama's going down, is because it's all been documented by the criminals themselves. These are some very sick, very vile, very demonic people. Because there is a form in the felony case file that is called an arrest and booking report. It's supposed to be 2 pages. There's only 1 page because the narrative section of it has conveniently been mysteriously lost, but I have it. And it's still sitting down at the Duval County jail in the records department. And the document that they are calling an arrest and booking report. It is an arrest and booking report, but it is not. That is the proof that a crime happened. Because it does not state any type of crime. It doesn't even list any real crime. It lists 2 real statutes, but not the description of the statute. It has no victim. It has no evidence, nor does the narrative describe any crime being happening. That's called a false arrest and booking report. That's a 3rd-degree felony. And that very same false arrest and booking report is sitting down in the felony case file at the Fourth Circuit clerk of the court's office. Got a copy of it. Still sitting there. It's sitting there. And they all see it. So, again, that's the documentation of the crime, and that's the ongoing crime. Because the record said that I was actually arrested for lewd and lascivious sexual battery when there is no document anywhere that says that. Because the document that is in the felony case file is a false arrest and booking report. It doesn't describe me committing any kind of crime. And again, no one committed that crime on that date here in Jacksonville, Florida, anywhere in the state of Florida. Period. There is no document anywhere that says no one committed lewd and lascivious sexual battery upon a minor, which is having some type of sexual contact with a child under the age of 16. Yet my record, the court case says that's what happened. My criminal history report from the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office itself says that there should be a document someplace that says it, but it isn't there. That's the crime. That is documentation of the cover-up. And again, keep it simple, stupid. You don't need to go any further than that. That may, because that is a lie, that means everything else that took place, that makes the case files, both of them. Because the second case file says solicitation of prostitution. There is no documentation of anyone violating that Florida statute. Statute on December 3rd, 1997, here in Jacksonville, Florida, in Duval County, Florida. So that's a lie. That means everything that case, every action in that case file is a lie. It's a criminal act. That's the crime. And who is it affecting? Me. They've stolen my life from me. Who wants to be around somebody? Who wants to be around someone who was even arrested or even accused of lewd or lascivious sexual battery? When the truth of the matter is, I'm a victim of sexual molestation myself. Now, the whole thing, if you want to see all the information, it's over on a YouTube channel. 6 hours of it, 103 videos. I'll show you everything. These people are going to prison. And that is the reason why they're trying to get me to violate some kind of crime. That's why they're continuing to agitate you. So you need to ask yourself, why has this gone on this long? Not why did they do what they did, because there was no legal, lawful reason for them to do what they did. What do you think that information was in the 250 pages of information I sent in to the person that's calling themselves the chief judge, the person that's calling themselves the sheriff, and the Honorable Mallory D. Cooper? It was their own information. They're upset that, I found out about it. I figured out what happened. But I didn't do it on my own. I was told by Almighty God. Everywhere I went, every piece of documentation of their crimes, signed, filled out in their own names, in their own handwriting. There is no legal, lawful reason for those case files to exist. And they want me to go down there and scream and shout and say, you have to do something about it. Nope. Now, when I sent it in, I sent it in on the 18th of July, 2015. They received it July 21st, 2015. At 10 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, I paid money to make sure that they got it. Because that's what they told me to do. Don't worry, we'll go back over it again. And it took them less than, I think it was 6 hours and 17 minutes before the person is calling himself the undersheriff, Pat Ivey, calls me up. Scared to death. Because what they did was they went through and they tried to find some kind of hook that they could get me on. Some kind of way to manipulate. Some kind of way to threaten me. Some kind of way to bully me. Well, I'm not a criminal. I'm doing what Almighty God told me to do. And I'm not scared. And I knew it was over with as soon as the man told me, as soon as Pat Ivey said, you have to. Oh, that's it. Over and done with. I don't have to do anything. You are obligated to do something. And what did he tell me I have to do? He said, you have to give us a couple of days. I mean, given y'all have had 19 years or 18 years, whatever the heck it was at the time that he called me. Why haven't y'all done anything about this yet? This should bother you all. It should really, truly bother you all. And again, all these people that say they're going to come take you out. No, look, if they wanted to take me out, they would have done it long before now. Because the cat is out of the bag now. The cat is out of the bag. And when you say, well, Kerry, what have you done? Well, let's see. I've gone into lawyers. I've been down to the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office. Into downtown. And met with an internal affairs or whatever the hell heck they call it. That's the guy that you report wrongdoings of the police department. And told him the same thing. I said, I need you to bring this arresting booking report and this arresting booking report. I said, you know what? Let me save you time. It doesn't exist. And then I pulled out the false arresting booking report. And what does he do? He urinates on himself. He then begins to tell me what I was doing. Oh, so now you're a mind reader. Back 19 years ago. The crime is there is no arrest and booking report when you all say that I was arrested for that. That's the crime. I don't care what you, then they always try to take you down a rabbit trail. Nope, stay focused. Stay focused. That's what I do. I stay focused. Keep it simple, stupid. James 4:17, therefore to him that knoweth to do good and does it not, to him it is sin. So this internal affairs detective commits like 7 or 8 third degree felonies right there in front of me in like 3 minutes, starts lying to me. He's looking at the false arrest and booking report. Looking right at it. Looking right at it. And then tells me, because it's the false arrest and booking report says that I was arrested for attempted lewd and lascivious act upon a minor. One little problem. The court itself says that there is no way to attempt that. That's like saying someone attempted to have walked across the room, because the statute says lewd and lascivious act committed, meaning it took place. If it doesn't take place, then you can't, then there is no way to attempt it. In fact, attempting it is a violation of the statute itself. And in order to violate that statute, you know what you kind of need? Oh, you need a child under the age of 16. They didn't have a victim because it didn't happen. We should never have to prove that something that never happened didn't happen. But they've gotten caught because they tried to cover it up. Again, over on the YouTube channel, 6 hours of it. 6 hours of it, 103 videos. I have their own little file. Okay? But this guy tells me, and remember, he's an internal affairs detective. And this guy sits there and looks at it and says, he says, I don't even know if these guys still work here. In other words, I don't know if I can do anything about it. You're the internal affairs detective, and you're telling me that you can't find out if somebody still works here or where they're at now. And I'm trusting you to keep me safe. Right. Now, folks, this is over and done with, folks. Over and done with. So, again, just keep it simple, stupid. You all are too egg I'm worried about justifying your actions. Keep it simple. Therefore, James 4:17, therefore to him, that's you, me, we, that knoweth to do good and does it not, to him it is sin. Just keep it simple, stupid. Just saying.